Hey everyone, and welcome back to another Unreal Tips and Tricks video. Today, we are going to be using the latest Product Configurator template that ships with Unreal 4.25. We'll be showing how to use your custom geometry, add our personalized configuration, and also get a basic understanding of how it is set up. Let's start by creating a new project, and let's select Automotive, Product Design, and Manufacturing. We can see that we have several templates to start your project. We are going to pick the Product Configurator and create the project from here. Here we are back in Unreal, and we can see that we have a scene set up for us. So let's go into play mode and see what we have. So first of all, we can see that we have our setup with a user interface. So we're going to be looking at the different buttons here. For example, this one allows me to go through different camera angles. The second one here allows me to switch between two lighting modes. Now the third one on the bottom here allows me to change the shape of the guitar. And finally, the fourth one here that we're going to be looking for the demo allows me to swap between different colors. So these are the items that we're going to be looking at today and import our custom mesh and use this template to drive our configurator. Now, you might be wondering how all of this is driven. Well, all of this configuration is using the variant set manager. So the basic functionality of the variant set is to record attributes of an actor such as transform properties, materials, and more. This is very useful for a configurator where you may want to show several color options or designs of the product. So let's go up to a folder and let's check the variant set. So if I double click on it, this will open a new tab for me with the variant manager. And we can immediately recognize the configuration variants we saw earlier in the user interface in play mode. Now let's go back to our World Outliner tab and let's select the level variant sets actor. This is where we will define which level variant set we will be using. Now, if we go up and look at the BP underscore configurator, this is where we can specify which level variant set actor we will use. And this will allow us to keep that interface and keep away from blueprints and only use the variant manager feature. We can already start by duplicating the default variant set and call this one variant set custom. And we'll come back to this one shortly. For this demo, I've imported a custom mesh that I'll be dragging into the viewport, and I'm going to start placing it in the scene. I'm going to make sure it's set to movable. I'm just going to place it right around where the guitar actor is set. Now, the next thing I want to do is parent the components to an actor. So I'm simply going to duplicate the guitar root by alt-dragging, and I'm going to rename this to headphones. I'm going to attach all of my components to it and keep things tidy. Now, we simply need to hide our guitar mesh by selecting the components and go into the details panel and make sure it's set to non-visible and check hidden in-game. I'm just going to reduce the size of those billboard actors. So I'm just going to select those two, go to my details tab and lower that value to 0.3. Okay, let's go into play mode and see if this works. So we now have our custom mesh displaying, but we still have the old information displaying on the configurator. So let's go back to our variant sets that we earlier duplicated, and let's open up this guy. I'm going to personalize this template for this demo and only use the features I find interesting for my scenario. But please feel free to explore all the different opportunities the variant manager offers. So in my case, I'll be keeping the two environment variants. For the cameras, I'm only going to be using two camera angles, so I'm going to delete these two. For the body shape, I'm not going to be using any of this old information. So I'm going to retain that variant though. So I'm going to name mine speaker cup, since this is the one I'm going to be using. And I'm going to delete these. We're going to bring all of our information later on. And same goes for body color. This is something I can keep. I'm just going to rename this headband color, since this is the part I'm going to be using. And I'm just going to delete all of this. And we're going to be doing the same for all of these parts, which essentially share the same properties. So I'm just going to press delete. And let's start with the camera variant. So what we want to do here is switch between two camera angles. First variant is called overview, which will be our starting view when launching the experience. So let's keep this variant as is for now. And the second one from a three-quarter angle that we will rename correctly to avoid confusion later on. Let's check how this looks. So I'm just going to go into view mode and select my config camera. And let's see what that does. So I'm here in overview mode. Now, if I switch to three quarters, I can see that it's slightly offset. So I'm going to be grabbing that camera target and it's highlighted here. So I'm just going to drag this bit more to the center. And as soon as I release, you can see that the value here is changed. So I'm going to apply this value. And now if I switch back to overview in three quarters, I have that new value stored, which is exactly what we wanted. Now, before we move on to the speaker cup variants, I want to change those thumbnails with my custom ones. If I right click on the variant, we can either import our own images or capture directly from the viewport. So let's switch to our overview mode and let's make sure that the actors are hidden by pressing G on the keyboard. And let's click on the overview variant, right click and set from viewport. Now let's do the same for the three quarter view, right click and set from viewport. Now for the speaker cups, what I'm going to be doing is create two variants. So one with the Unreal logo that you're currently seeing and the other one with some more fancy RGB lighting. So I'm going to be clicking on the plus sign here and create my first variant. And I'm going to rename this UE logo. Now I'm going to go to my rolled outliner tab and I'm going to be grabbing this mesh and this mesh. So I'm going to drag this over to the variant manager. And as soon as I let go on this first variant, it's going to prompt me a message asking me what properties I'd like to change. Since I'll be just hiding and unhiding the mesh, I can simply type in visibility. And this is going to give me that property. So I'm going to assign that property to that mesh. Now for the second variant, I'm simply going to duplicate the first variant. So let's go ahead, right click and duplicate. And let's rename this to UE logo RGB. And what I'm going to be doing is simply grab that RGB mesh and I'm going to drag that to the second one here. And same as above, we're going to simply type in visible and assign that. Now I want to be hiding these two first ones. So I'm going to select those two and untick those and make sure this one is set to visible. Now, what happens if I switch between the two is that we can see that our two meshes are correctly displaying. I'm also going to be using the same technique as before for the thumbnails for my speaker cups. Now, for the headband color, all I need to do is create a new variant. So I'm going to click on the plus sign and I'm going to name this black. Now I'm going to go into the world outliner and select the headphone frame and I'm going to drag this into my color variant. And this time we want to change our material property. So let's simply type in material and we can see this showing up with element 0, which is essentially my material ID. Now if we look on the bottom right, we can actually see in the details panel of the mesh that this is the material property we'll be changing. So I'm going to check this and I'm going to press select. I'm just going to expand the window a little so we can see our variant properties a bit better, and we can see our material property captured. Now, all I have to do for my second variant is duplicate the first variant and rename this to red. And I'm going to change the value to my custom materials that I've set earlier on. Now, if I click on the red variant, we can see that those properties are changing for the material, which is exactly what we want. I'm going to repeat this task for my other colors and see you shortly. One last step before we hit play, we need to specify that new variant set to the level variant actor we mentioned earlier. So I'm just going to go in the world outliner and select level variant sets actor. And I'm simply going to specify that I'm going to be using this new one. Now let's hit play. And we can immediately see that we have a cleaned up interface with our new system. So if I go into the camera, I can swap between the two angles that we've set earlier on. I still have the two environments, so I can see the different lightings. Now, if I go into my speaker cup, I can switch between the normal logo and the RGB lighting. I can rotate the object and check different angles, which is pretty cool. And finally, I can change the headband color. I hope you enjoyed this video and see you very soon in the next Unreal Tips and Tricks series.